Sports Frenzy time.
What's up, Frenzy Head Nation? It is that time again.
Yes.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Yes, it is.
Oh, yes.
Just so you Red Wing fans out there are curious, currently it is the first period, 12 minutes and 43 seconds, and the Red Wings are leading 2-0.
Woo-hoo! Go Wings!
Go
Got
Wings!
Got that game on right here, too.
That's funny.
Whoa! Oh my goodness, look at that!
What?
It finally came in.
What did?
It's been on back order for, like, ever.
Oh, your new head?
My new head!
I know! It's so pretty, look at that! Oh! I know, right?
It was time for a new change, you know?
Hey.
It's a new image.
There
a
you
new
go.
New Tim.
You never know.
New coach, here we go.
Just to give everybody a heads up, it's getting warmer out. I might have a buzz cut soon.
A buzz cut?
It,
no way.
Yes, I might have a skinhead here in a little bit.
Oh, I don't believe it.
I'm
no
contemplating
way.
It. I am contemplating it, but...
Are you really?
I am.
Wow.
I am. Oh! Trivia. So
trivia. What?
Yes. Our new segment, trivia.
This time of night.
Yes, that's right. It's only 10:31. But anyways, we got three questions this weekend. Last week was NBA, so this week we're gonna do NHL hockey.
Oh.
Playoff. It's more about the Stanley Cup, I guess you should say.
Since
we're gearing up towards, since it's playoff time. First question. Who has won the most Stanley Cups? A. Red Wings. B. Maple Leafs. C. The Canadiens. D. The Bruins. So, like I said, at the... You okay?
I'm okay, yeah.
Okay. Need some water?
Are you okay?
Here, you can have some more. Here, have some of my water.
Oh, yeah, that's cool, refreshing, crisp. I feel much better now.
I just realized we just shared a glass. Thing. We just shared the same glass, Tim. Anyway.
Don't matter.
It doesn't matter. It's not like we kiss, so. But anyways. How much does the Stanley Cup weigh, Tim? A, 50 pounds. B, 20.5 pounds. C, 34.5 pounds. Or D, 15 pounds.
Okay.
And then our last question. The Stanley Cup has not been awarded twice since it was created. In 2005, obviously, because of the lockout. What was the other year? A, 1900. B, 1919. C, 1923. Or D, 1935. A couple of these are making harder tonight.
These are some tough ones. I'm clueless on some of these. Well, I'm clueless on all of them, really, but...
Well, there you go. You guys are going to learn something new tonight, so...
Yep. It'll be like a historical moment right here.
Hey, it's all for fun. So at the very end of the show, I will give you the answers to these questions, so you guys can have a little time to ponder over them. If you need
you
to rewind, if you need time to rewind, you know me to re-say them, rewind the video, do whatever you got to do. Pause the video. Feel free to do whatever you want. So, but anyways, let's get to these picks.
Let's do it.
Speaking of hockey, NHL playoff hockey.
The action.
It is. First one, we have the 26-18-4 New York Rangers versus the 27-18-3 Washington Capitals. Right now, the Capitals lead the series 1-0.
Okay, now, this is playoff time.
Yes.
Just so I know, really. And congrats to Jamie for putting these sheets together for us this week. Are these away team and home teams accurate on this list? Did it matter who did it or no?
Actually, now that I'm looking at it, I'm not quite sure if the home team And because I got him off of ESPN, and they're just kind of, it looks like they're just kind of throwing him up here and not
okay.
really.
Just worry about for this part of it.
Okay, one
Don't
sec.
Worry about the home team and away team part of things, everybody.
Yep, so I'll try to work on that, but it was kind of hard to.
Kind of big deal. I was just curious. I just wanted to know for sure.
One.
I mean, yeah, that's kind of tricky when you're in playoff.
Yeah.
Time.
Yeah. I believe this game is going to be. The Capitals have home field advantage there. So the next game should be in Washington too, I believe.
Okay.
So.
Good call.
Who do you got, Tim?
Oh, let's see. We have 26-18-4, 27-18-3. Wow. I'm gonna go with the Washington Capitals.
I also have the Washington Capitals.
Advantage, home ice, so you know.
Yep. Let me real quick see if I can do some on the fly research to find out who is the home court advantage. That was just for the fun of it. Okay. This next one here. 26-17-5 Toronto Maple Leafs versus the 28-14-6 Boston Bruins. The Bruins lead the series 1-0, and the next game will be in Boston.
And I'm going with Boston.
I also have Boston. Boston. This next one. Actually, now that I'm looking at this right, I think I did do them right.
So good.
I think the home is right and the away is right, I believe. I'll keep my eye on it here as we go on. But anyway,
we're still good.
30-12-5 Anaheim Ducks versus the 24-16-8 Detroit Red Wings, and that is a 3-point bonus game.
It is a 3-point bonus game.
And like I said, currently
that means it's worth 3 points.
That's right, three of them. And like I said, currently in game two, the Red Wings are leading 2-0. Oh, and wait, I got a new friend too.
You do?
I got a Red Wings gnome.
No way.
And he says, "Let's go Red Wings. Let's go Red Wings."
Does he have the squid on top of his head?
No, he's got a little stocking hat, and he's got a puck and a stick.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I almost got you the one with the squid on top of his head.
Ooh. Oh, yeah, just to let you know, if you want your own Michigan gnome, or Red Wings gnome, or Tigers gnome, or maybe even a Lions gnome, Myers has them on clearance right now for, I believe, $5 right now.
What?
Yep.
Are you kidding me?
No. They're usually like $20, but my wife found this for me. She brought that home for me.
Oh, man. I'm going to head to Myers.
I know. But anyways, who do you got, Tim?
Oh, I've got the Red Wings. So hopefully at the end of the night, this series will be tied up at 1-1. But right now, the Ducks lead it by 1, correct?
Correct. Correct. Yep, that's right too. Okay, this next one is correct too, the home and away. 29-17-2, St. Louis Blues versus the
2.
Blues versus the 27-16-5 LA Kings. Currently, the Blues lead the series 1-0. And like I said, it is in L.A.
And L.A. has a home field? Okay.
Yep.
I am going with the Blues.
I also have the Blues. Next up. We have the 25-17-6 Ottawa Senators versus the 29-14-5 Montreal Canadiens, and currently the Senators lead the series 1-0.
All right, could you repeat those again for me, please?
The stats?
Yeah, for some reason you cut out. I'm not sure why.
Okay.
On my end, anyway.
Senators are 25-17-6.
Six, okay.
And the Canadiens are 29-14-5.
Five, okay. And does Montreal have the home field advantage?
That's what I'm checking on as we speak. Yeah, they were slow at getting up. Who had the home court advantage? Yes, Montreal does have home court.
Okay.
I'm going with Montreal.
Is there a leader in this series right now or no?
The Senators lead 1-0.
1-0. Yeah, I think I'm going to go with Montreal also.
Okay, 24-17-7 New York Islanders versus the 36-12 Pittsburgh Penguins. The Penguins lead the series 1-0. And Penguins do have home field advantage.
Wow, so far you've had these in order then. I am going with the Penguins.
I also have Penguins. 26-19-3 Minnesota Wild versus the 36-7-5 Chicago Blackhawks. The Blackhawks currently lead the series 1-0, and it is in Chicago the next game.
Okay. Yeah, I'm going to go with Chicago on that one.
Me also. Chicago. Oh. Then our last playoff game for the week, 25-16-7 San Jose Sharks versus the 26-15-7 Vancouver Canucks. Currently the Sharks lead the series 1-0, and check it. It is in Vancouver, so the Canucks have home court.
Okay. I am going with the Sharks.
I also have Sharks. NBA action. I only have one NBA action because when I set up these sheets, this was the only for sure game being played Friday. So, but now there's a few others, I do believe.
We can update them in a little bit here.
Okay.
What's going on with the other games?
Cool. We have the 56-26 LA Clippers versus the 56-26 Memphis Grizzlies. The Grizzlies lead the series 3-2.
Wow, really?
Yes.
3-2, huh?
Yes.
And do the Grizzlies have the home court advantage here?
Doing it on the fly.
Yes, you are.
I'm going as fast as I can, Captain. Yes, Memphis does have home court advantage.
Okay. I'm going to give it to Memphis then.
Ooh, I got LA. I think LA will hold on. They will hold on.
My philosophy on it is with Memphis having the home court advantage, the crowd's going to be pretty into it.
Yeah, that's true.
Why I'm giving them the advantage there.
Well, there you go. All these at Major League Baseball games, these are good to go. These are all correct home and away. So they are, as you see on your sheet.
Ask that every time is what you're telling me?
Huh?
I said, so I don't need to ask that every time is what you're telling me?
Yeah, yeah. There was just the hockey ones. That was the only one I wasn't sure on. So, Major League Baseball, the 12-12 Minnesota Twins versus the 12-13 Cleveland Indians. Make me smack you.
Boy, this is a tough one. I'm going to go Cleveland on this one.
Ooh, I got Minnesota. Next up, 15 and 14 Cincinnati Reds versus the 11 and 16 Chicago Cubs.
Jeez, oh Pete.
I'm going with the Reds.
Yeah, I think I am too.
16 and 13 Oakland Athletics versus the 17 and 10 New York Yankees. And I'm going with the Athletics because I hate the Yankees.
I'm not a Yankees fan either, but I'm going to give it to the Yankees.
Oh, Tim.
I know, right?
19-8 Boston Red Sox versus the 17-10 New York Rangers. I'm going with Boston.
Yep, I'm going with Boston as well.
11-15 Chicago White Sox versus the 15-10 Kansas City Royals.
Wow. 11-15. I'm going to give it to the Royals.
I also have Royals. 15-11 Detroit Tigers versus the 8-20 Houston Astros, and that is your other 3-point bonus game.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
And, of course, I have the Tigers.
Go Tigers.
12-15. Rays. Where are the Rays? Tampa Bay Rays. Sorry.
That's all right.
Versus the 17-11 Denver Rockies, or Colorado Rockies, I should say. Not Denver, but it is in Denver, I believe. Colorado Rockies.
I'm going with the Rockies.
Rockies also. 16-12 Baltimore Orioles versus the 10-17 Anaheim Angels. Wasn't it last year I had such a hard time saying Orioles?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm going with the Orioles just because I can say it now.
Yeah, you've nailed it this year.
Yes!
Good job. Way to improve. And that's who I'm going with as well.
13-14 L.A. Schoonover Dodgers versus the 16-12 San Francisco Giants.
Giants record? 16-12. Okay. And it was 13-14 for the Dodgers?
Dodgers, yes.
Huh. They're not doing so good, are they?
Nope.
I guess I'm going with the Giants. Sorry, Scooney.
14-14 Washington Nationals versus the 16-12 Pittsburgh Pirates.
Arr, I be taking the Pirates, arr.
Arr, me as well. Arr, me matey. Oh!
Got the Pirates.
Oh! Roll it! I know, I had to give a good one because I wasn't feeling so hot there on Sunday, recap show. So I'm feeling good now, so I had to make up for it. Yes.
All right, so who I got this week?
I got Kyle, you got Kurt.
I got Kurt this week. I don't want Kurt.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go.
I'm gonna start breaking rules and telling you no, I'm taking Kyle all the time now.
What? But we got what? You can't do that.
I know, that'd be against our brother code.
It would. Well, yeah. Well, technically, you could do that actually, but yeah, it would be against your brother code.
No. It just doesn't work for us.
No, it wouldn't. So, okay.
It's kind of funny that really, you know, the racing for us. You know, it used to be almost like, I don't know, we didn't know anything about it, so we just did this. And now suddenly Kyle's become like a good racer, so we actually sometimes get points from this.
Yeah, well, you do, not me. What are you talking about? Oh, man, we got a final on the NBA game here. We have the Nets and the Bulls. That game is going to go to Game 7.
Really?
Yes, the Nets just beat the Bulls to make it Game 7, so they're tied 3-3, and the Nuggets and Warriors just started, so nothing really worth mentioning. And
apparently, in warm-ups for this game, just for having fun, a couple of the Nets players went out and attacked Chicago's Bull and started beating them up.
Really? That's kind of funny.
You can see, if you guys want to see this, they have footage of it on the ESPN website.
Well, we'll have to put that up
it's
on
like
the...
second clip.
We'll have to put that up on the blog there, so... and then also, the Senators beat the Canadiens to go up 1-1, and the Capitals beat the Rangers 3-1 to go up 1-0. And it's almost at the end of the first period, and the Red Wings still lead 2-0 over the Ducks. And second period of the Kings versus the Blues, and the Kings lead 1-0. So there's that. NBA news. The NBA has fined Golden State Warriors coach Mark Jackson $25,000 on Thursday for making public comments in an attempt to influence the officiating in the Warriors playoff series with Denver. But that's all I got. What do you got, Tim?
Did you see the Red Wings game just went into its first intermission there?
Yes.
So it's 3-0 right now?
It's 2-0.
2-0.
Yep.
Okay. All right. Well, what I have to start off with is a little NBA action. Now, this goes back to something we talk about a lot called good sportsmanship. These teams tend to forget about good sportsmanship. The New York Knicks apparently thinking that they were going to close out Boston in this game decided it would be funny to wear all black uniforms. A tasteless attempt of what happened. Well, guess what? They not only made fools of themselves, but they lost that game as well and fired up Boston.
Yes.
The thing that irritates me about this a little bit is the coach, they have been talking to the coach about it, and he claims he knew nothing about this and that he thought it was a classless act too. And was very disappointed in his players. Well, I don't know. Correct me if I'm wrong, but isn't the coach usually with the team when they're getting the uniforms on? What were you doing, coach? Where were you if you didn't know they were putting these uniforms on?
Yeah.
That's just crazy as far as I'm concerned. But that's a Coach Cole rant right there.
Well, that's okay.
I mean, come on, you're the coach of the team. You can't tell me you didn't know that your players were going to wear these black uniforms? Or when you're going out there, you couldn't question that at all? Like, hey, where's your guys' regular uniforms? All right. That's enough of my ranting.
Breathe.
Let's see. What else did I have here?
Breathe, Tim. Breathe.
Flip Saunders is the new president.
Ooh.
Yeah, long. Yeah, Flip Saunders. He goes. That guy's been a lot of places.
He has.
Anyway.
He changes teams about as often as he changes his underwear.
Confirmed tonight, he signed a long-term deal to become the president of basketball operations, and he will hold a minority ownership stake in the team. With Saunders as part owner, longtime owner Glenn Tyler is expected to take the team off the market. Oh, wow, okay. Because they've been looking for buyers to keep the team in Minneapolis. So, there you go. It looks like they found their...
So they are staying in Minneapolis.
It looks like they are now with Flip Saunders taking part ownership of the team. It says the Godfather-style deal with Saunders, who coached the Wolves from 95 to 2006, is similar to the arrangement Pat Riley has at the Miami Heat. This seems to be a thing of the future. These coaches who, they come back for some kind of operations or something like that, and then not only do they get like a job as the operations, but they either become owner or somehow have a controlling effort and say in the team. That's becoming a popular thing these days.
Well, isn't that what Phil Jackson wants?
That's kind of, yeah, that's what I'm hearing, that if he's ever going to come back to anything, that's what he wants, is something like that. So, this is what this is the deal that Flip's got, and it looks like it's going to be, not only does it work out for him, but it also looks like it's going to keep the Timberwolves in Minnesota. So, there you go.
Well, there we go.
Making news on that. I'm just scanning things here real quick. Let me see if there's anything else right off the top.
Have you
I see there's something about NCAA suspends rule change on unlimited tech.
Oh, yeah, well, that I read that, and it's nothing too big. All it is I guess before, like, if you were thinking about going to a team, the coaches and all of them could text those players they are interested in. Well, no longer the NCAA has decided, no, you can't text them anymore. So, that's it.
Okay,
yeah,
well, that's it.
Yeah, it wasn't anything really. I was like, oh, I wonder what that is. And no, it's not interesting. Who cares? You can't text a prospect. Call them then. Send them a letter in the mail. Send them an email.
Well, you know, that really hurts because, you know, let's face it, these kids today, all they like to do is text. So,
yeah.
If you want to talk to your future recruits, you probably should text them.
I don't know.
You see, they call in the play to the quarterback now by a text. Pull his phone out real quick and sees what the next play is
going to
be.
Oh, shotgun. Oh, okay, that's what we're doing, okay. No, not actually.
Not really, but, you know, that's just how these...
Give it time. Eventually a screen will pop down in their helmets and it'll... Oh, okay, that's the play, okay. It no longer is hand gestures and stuff like that. I think now, don't they have radios? Do they have radios in college or is that just in the pros?
I think it's some they do. I don't think all colleges have that yet. Yeah, because I still see a lot of hand signals out there.
Yeah.
My favorites are the ones you have all three, like if a team has like four quarterbacks or whatever.
Yeah.
The three other quarterbacks all got a different hand signal, so nobody knows what the hell they're calling.
Yeah, yep. Yep, exactly, so... that's all I'm seeing.
And, the only other news I have is apparently John Cena's injury that everybody was, like, talking about, making a big deal about. At this point, unless they're hiding something, it's nowhere near as bad as we thought it was. They went from it being a tear to a severe bruise. So, I don't know. I mean, he had his... For Monday Night Raw, they were taping it pretty heavily. So, I don't know. I'm not sure on that. But I guess we'll just have to stay tuned and see.
Let's see. Stupid thing, stop. Work with me, computer. Stupid thing. I was trying to see how long it would take to heal a bruised Achilles tendon. One second.
I imagine that would take a little while, especially if you're putting any pressure on it or, you know, anything like that. It's gotta hurt. And the beatings those guys take, I would think even with a bruise, that even just having tape on it would hurt that quite a bit.
Begin exercising your tendon after the majority of your healing has taken place. This should be between 10 to 20 days when the majority of your pain has ceased. You will want to work on stretching the tendon back out. A sports therapist can give you specific exercises to work on at home until you are ready to get active again. So apparently 10 to 20 days, which, I mean, really, Cena didn't really do that much. And basically all it is they say to, you know, wrap it and ice it and looks like put heat on it too, so. But
I will say this. I have never been a huge John Cena fan, never, for the most part. But give him, I mean, mad props for all the work he does with Make-A-Wish Foundation. It just amazes me how much stuff he does for Make-A-Wish,
yep.
And I love that. That is very cool.
Yeah, that was really cool what he did this past Monday. He brought three Make-A-Wish kids and made them superstars, WWE superstars.
Yeah, they were all honorary WWE superstars, yeah. And they all came up with their own stage name and everything, so it was really cool.
Yep. I don't think they've ever done anything like that, so that'd be a real honor there, so, but... But that's all I got. You got anything else, Tim?
I got nothing else. I'm like, oh no, it's trivia time.
It is trivia. It's the answer time. Tim, who has won the most Stanley Cups? Who do you got?
What were the choices again? Let's give them the choices again.
Okay.
So I can hear as well.
A, Red Wings. B, Maple Leafs. C, Canadiens. Or D, the Bruins.
I'm going to go with the Red Wings.
Ron.
Oh.
The answer is C, the Montreal Canadiens with 24 Stanley Cups.
Wow.
Their last one was in 1993. So it's been a little while, but... how much does the Stanley Cup weigh? A, 50 pounds. B, 20.5 pounds. C, 34.5 pounds, or D, 15 pounds?
Alright, before I answer this, I'm going to say this. I remember you told me there's like several Stanley Cups for like the touring and things like that.
Yes.
So... just for the purpose of this question, and you might not even know the answer to this one, do all those Stanley Cups weigh the same, or do each Stanley Cup...
Yeah, they're all the same. I believe that each one of those Stanley Cups has the same information, the same... They should be exactly the same.
Identical, then.
Yep.
Okay, and you... can you give me the rundown on those numbers one more time, please?
Okay, it's 50... 20.5, 34.5, or 15, all in pounds.
I'm going to go with 20.5.
Ron. C, 34.5 pounds.
I was originally going to go, that was my original answer, but then I just saw the picture on TV with the guy holding it above his head, shaking it and everything, and I'm like, oh, if it's like that heavy, like, you wouldn't be doing that and skating on there, too.
34.5, yeah.
Wow,
that's
kind of impressive.
It's not a light trophy. It is not a light trophy.
I mean, it just really looked like it was light, too. That's why I changed my dang answer. I would have had it right. I should have went with my gut instinct.
You always go with your gut instinct, Tim. And our last one. The Stanley Cup has not been awarded twice since it was created. The second time in 2005 for the lockout. true fact, actually. On the Stanley Cup, it says, in 2005, it says, no season, or Stanley Cup not awarded, or something like that, flat out on the Stanley Cup. But anyways, what was the other year? A, 1900. B, 1919. C, 1923. Or D, 1935.
I had no idea with this one, so I'm just going to throw out a guess and say 1923.
The answer is B, 1919. The reason is because of the Spanish flu epidemic.
Oh, wow.
Yes, that was the other year, 1919. So, that's it.
Trivia.
That's okay, Tim. It's just for fun. But that's all I got. So.
And that's all I got. So, yeah.
Cool.
I am a coach.
I'm Jamie, and this is the Red Wing Gnome.
The Red Wing Gnome. Wow. Good to see you, buddy. Welcome to the club.
Yeah, buddy.
We'll have to get them all together for a photo shoot sometime.
I'm down.
Anyway, everybody have a great week. And if you're not down with that,
we got two words for you. Break it down. You can tell me.